Hi folks, if this is the first time you're viewing my content, my name is Lachlan and I live on the outskirts of Durban, South Africa, which is a city by the sea on the country's east coast. I went to college to study journalism, and those who are familiar with my videos will already know that. But today I want to tell you about a particular aspect of the experience which I think is important to make known, and that is my experience of direct racism and discrimination as a student. Now, the college I attended was a small private one, and funnily enough had its campus in the center of a shopping mall of all places. And the class that I was a member of was a small one as well, comprising only about 10 students, of which I was the only non-black. Now, when you're a white person in South Africa, this is nothing strange or unusual, as unlike in Europe and North America, whites are the ethnic minority in this country. So what that meant was, generally speaking, I got along with the other students and had no problems. The only real difference was that, as I'm sure you can understand, often when you study journalism, you have to discuss difficult topics. So when issues of historical racial discrimination, for which South Africa is well known, arose in class, I knew that my best course of action would simply be to keep quiet and only speak when spoken to on the subject. And generally, this kept things even and peaceful for me. However, there was one student who almost from the very first day classes began, decided he didn't like me simply because I'm white. What this led to was him seeking out any excuse, no matter how small, to start fights and arguments. And it made things very difficult for me because, if you can't tell by the way I move, I am physically disabled. And the disabled in South Africa already exists on the edges of our society. So I'm socially awkward to begin with. And my first experience of being out in the adult world was made difficult by the constant threat of confrontation from this guy, because he viewed me as a symbol of everything that other white people had done wrong to members of his family. This made having to attend lectures always slightly uneasy for me, because I'd be constantly wondering whether he'd find a reason to fight with me that day. There is one particular incident that stands out in my memory. Now, because of the college's physical situation, the room in which we attended lectures was not like a traditional lecture hall that you'd see in a standard university, because the college was more or less just a set of rooms in an office block. So in order to get in and out of our lecture room, one had to move through a narrow passageway to get to the door. And one day, after lectures had been concluded, this guy was sitting on the floor reading a book and blocking the exit. So when it came time for me to leave, I asked him politely to get up and move out of my way so that so that I could get going. And immediately, he took this as a great insult. He asked me if I thought I was his boss because of the color of my skin, and whether I thought I had the right to just make him move whenever I wanted to. And this was really difficult for me because I'm not a naturally aggressive person. But by the end of this pointless argument, I basically just told him to shut up and move, which thankfully he did. Another strange aspect of his behavior is that even in the midst of being needlessly aggressive and confrontational, there were many days where he would suddenly decide to be friendly and act as if none of this aggression or anger even existed. So it left me often feeling confused and unsure of how to behave. Sadly, none of the other students ever stood up to him and came to my defense, most likely because they did not want to have the trouble of arousing his anger and having to deal with being called a sellout or a traitor to their race, as aggressive black people often do with those who think more logically. I'm not entirely sure how I should end this story, but I just wanted to make it clear that racial discrimination is not by any means owned and perpetrated only by whites. Anyone can do it to anyone else, and anyone can be a victim. Because if you believe that all humans are fundamentally equal and should be treated the same as I do, then you know that all humans are equally capable of wrongdoing. For now, farewell.